Because I'm a second-year college student, a lot of people ask me, "Oh, Gaurav, what did you wish you knew as a freshman in college?" And I've never had an answer to that question, and also the story's made up, but UC Davis made a video called What I Wish I'd Known as a Freshman. So because I didn't have an answer, and again, that story's made up, no one asked for my input on anything, let's see what Davis students of 2012 said that they wished they knew as a freshman.
As a freshman, I wish I knew. When I was a freshman, I wish.
One thing I wish that I had taken advantage of freshman year.
You can tell me.
I really wish I knew more about.
About what?
I wish I had known.
What did you wish you'd known?
Something I wish I knew as a freshman coming here to UC Davis.
Tell me what you knew.
Every year, more than 5,000 students begin classes at UC Davis. By the time they leave, there are many things they wish they would have known when they first stepped onto campus.
Huh. So the entire intro was just a bunch of teasers to draw you into the video and make you watch it. Which I think is a low blow. I would never do something like that, like, I don't know, make a fake story to start the video just to draw viewers' attention. Yeah. Never me.
I wish I would have taken advantage of my professors.
Oh.
And TA's office hours.
Oh, and his office hours. So take advantage of the professor and then take advantage of the professor's office hours. It's true. You got to take advantage of your professors, you know, just get some dirt on them, blackmail them. And also, corruption doesn't just stop with getting into college. There's corruption once you're in college. So next time you turn in a paper, maybe slide a crisp 20 and then a little sticky note that says,
"Hey, I have dirt on you, and if you don't give me a good grade on this, bad things are gonna happen to you, okay?"
And that should get you a good grade. Always take advantage of your professors.
When I was a freshman, I just felt like I thought, you know, oh, I got an UC, I'm the smartest kid in my high school, and I came in thinking I knew everything.
Well, yeah, that's... Is that not true? When I got into UC, I immediately cut off all my friends. I was like, I'm smarter than all of you, I don't need you, okay? Just me and my brain, taking on the world. All that love and, you know, having a nice relationship with someone, I'm a UC student, baby. I don't need that stuff.
But in all honesty, it's okay if you don't know anything, because many of the freshmen will find out that they're not the smartest kids anymore.
I'm not gonna lie. That cut a little deep, okay? There is truth to what he just said. If you come into college with good study habits and strong work ethic, then you should be good. But college definitely shows your weaknesses and your study habits. Like, cramming isn't as effective in college as it is in high school. But then again, I'm also in a UC, so I'm much smarter than people, so I still cram for stuff. Because once again, and I can't stress this enough, I'm much smarter than people because I go to a UC. This is sarcasm, by the way, so I don't want anyone to take that seriously. I think I've said it a lot of times. It's a joke, okay?
If you think you're gonna be cool, try to text and ride your bike.
I mean, yeah, I use my phone on my bike because I want to be cool. That's the only reason. I'm not even doing anything on my phone, I just have it open on the home screen. Just so that when people see me riding my bike, they're like, "Oh damn, that's a cool guy right there."
You might want to go to the bank because you will get a ticket.
Okay, yes, but if you're using your phone on your bike, you're probably really cool and successful, so the ticket won't even matter.
Talk to as many people as you can, get to know people. I think coming in, you know, your first year, you might be a little intimidated walking through campus, not knowing anybody, but it's like, you know, here's your chance to like get to know everybody.
Well, not everybody. A lot of people here, so. But it's true, there's a lot of people here, so there's a very wide variety of types of people. And so it's usually a good idea to reach out of your comfort zone and meet people, and you'll get a bunch of new friends. But Gaurav, why don't you have friends? Okay, well, it's, you know, I just, shut up, okay?
I wish I had known never to go into the Death Star alone. It's a big building, it's easy to get lost, and as confident as you are, you need a friend to go with you.
Very true. Never go in the Death Star alone. Always take an old man with you that's gonna hold off Darth Vader so that you can run away in your flat, crappy ship and then watch him die. Never go in the Death Star alone, okay?
Eat less DC cookies for these
guys. Oh.
At first you're like, oh, he means, you know, eat less cookies for your health. But he's like, no. He's like, eat less DC cookies, specifically with these guys, because they take all my cookies. I mean, eat all the cookies you want, but don't take Chad and Brad with you, okay? They're little cookie monsters, I tell you what.
You have to space out your soft serve, because when you first get here, you eat the whole ice cream every day.
Did he just say you eat the whole ice cream every day? Is this guy going to every single dining common and just taking all the ice cream and eating it? That's terrifying.
But eventually you get sick of it, so now I'm sick of it after like 4 years.
Oh my god. It took him 4 years to get sick of ice cream? I mean, he's gotta be eating like 7 gallons a day, at least. How'd it take him 4 years to get sick of it? I'll eat ice cream like 3 days in a row and I'm like, whoo. Let's slow down, Garv, okay? Taking it a bit far, guy. But Chad is like, yeah, you know, I kind of got sick of ice cream. Oh, how much were you eating? Oh, you know, like a couple gallons a day. Oh my god, how long did you do this for? Oh, not that long, you know, like 4 years. Oh my god, that's so unhealthy. Yeah, I'm gonna die soon.
You don't want the freshman 15.
Yeah, watch out for that.
He says watch out for that like it's a monster that's gonna creep up on you. It's like you're just in a room watching videos and then all of a sudden... Did you hear that? What is that? Oh my god, it's a freshman 15!
For me, there's a lot of things that you can get involved in. Just off the bat, you don't really hear about them unless you look for them. And by the time I knew about them and got involved, I was already a senior.
What? It took this guy 4 years to realize that these clubs you can get involved with? Holy crap. Like every day he's just walking through campus, seeing all of these signs, all of these little things around, flyers on the wall that's like, oh, come to this outing. And for 3 years he doesn't think anything of it. But then he becomes a senior and he's like, oh my god, there's like 1,000 clubs here. And you can join these clubs. I mean, I'm gonna join a club.
Bike circles. Bike circles are important. They only go one way. Sometimes the senior's right that you can go the other way and you can't.
You can tell that guy has definitely been through something in a bike circle. Like, there's definitely some weird passive aggression he feels right now. He's like, bike circles, they only go one way. But I guess not everyone knows that, because I got hit by some idiot going the wrong way.
As a freshman, I wish I knew about how quiet the library was.
Excuse me? Did this man just say, I wish I knew how quiet the libraries are? There's no way he goes to this school, because this is a UC, and UC kids are very smart. How did he not know libraries were quiet? Did he think there were, like, concerts playing in them?
I really wish I knew more about, I guess, more diversity in the classes I took, because I was an engineering major, and I took only engineering classes, and until I took the first, like, dramatic arts class, like, I didn't know what I wanted to do, really. So I really encourage people to go out and take more classes outside of their comfort zone.
I mean, I agree with that 100%. You should take as many classes as you can outside your comfort zone, you know, to grow as a person. I've been told that I need to do that more, and apparently taking more cool classes will do that. The only hard part is every quarter you have to pay a lot of money to be here. So usually you just try to take what your degree needs, you know, like the bare minimum, and get out of here. But if you do find those places where you can take maybe a GE here, a GE there, what? Whenever you can find that slot to find a GE and, you know, learn something cool, I would totally do it. So yeah, from experienced freshmen, I guess those are all things that if you're a freshman, you should know. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure you like this video and subscribe if you want to. And to celebrate the end of the video, why don't you go and get yourself a couple gallons of ice cream? Because, I mean, hey, you're not gonna get sick of it for another 4 years.